Hi and welcome to Friday's live trading. It's Charlie and it is actually 8:47. I'd started the recording earlier but I messed up and I had the camera on and then it didn't stop working, so I'm starting again. We haven't traded as yet. I'm with our swing traders today, and so you get an idea of a load of swing traders in with me today. So we are using Zoom today for our swing session, but we are looking for any old sort of trades. But as I was just going through with the guys, of course we've just had, if I go back out and go to the likes of the euro dollar and the stock and the S&P and the likes, we had some pretty decent reversals yesterday, whether it's euro, pound, the stock market, these are all daily charts here, the stock markets and whatnot. There's no point in me going for a big review of what they've done. You all know what they've done. So really what it's about is looking for fresh trades. So that's what we're looking for. And so what I'm already in trades on the S&P. I shorted with our swing traders at the beginning of the week. And I'm already in trades on the euro dollar, which I shorted yesterday. So what I am looking for, though, is a position on the dollar CAD. So if the dollar CAD can pull back a bit here today, I'm actually looking out to my 4-hour bands. So if we can come down to my lower band here on the 4-hour chart this morning, then that's what I'm going to be looking for to buy dollar CAD. I quite like dollar CAD overall. It's got nice, one of my members alerted me to this wonderful channel here on dollar CAD. So it's come off of that lower channel here yesterday. So there's some other reasons to want to buy rather than the fact it's just come off of that. But I'm a dollar bull at the moment anyway. So I'm looking for, dollar bullish type positions. So sorry, coming back to the dollar CAD. So that's what we're looking for there. So just to disclose, I've already got open positions, like I've already said, on euro dollar and the S&P and stuff. Nothing major at the moment, but they are already there. So anything I take is, those are already there. It's about today. It's about can I find any other trades? So this morning could be dollar CAD. If I can get some long positions in on a pullback. This afternoon, going into the US stock markets, then we'll be looking to see how these markets are gonna move. We're seeing a bounce this morning in the S&P. If we go back to the hourly chart here of the S&P, we can see that's bouncing this morning. But is that going to hold? Are we going to roll over? And that will be where it gets interesting from a intraday perspective later today. So I'm not interested in trading this morning and putting more shorts in, because I'm already short from not that far above up in this zone around 38.80 roughly anyway. So but it's possible that we could be shorting it if it's rolling over with a bit of price momentum there later today. But anyway, I don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves. It's only 10 to 9, so I'll press pause for now. Okay, just back here, and it's now 1 o'clock. Chatting with the guys all morning, and then I've just had a training session. So the dollar CAD, which is what I was looking for a bit more of a pullback this morning to get long, didn't pull back enough and has run away from me. So nothing has happened. Just been chatting with the guys here this morning. We've had a great morning, and but no trading activity. So and that was very much like what it was like yesterday for me. You know, although yesterday on the euro dollar got in the end, but really I didn't get in till 6 o'clock last night, sort of just after this candle. So that was when it broke. So but didn't trade all day prior to that. So it's that's the way it goes sometimes. So I can't always guarantee what's going to happen. Let's have a look at the S&P. But realistically, I'm just waiting. Yes, I'm already short the S&P. It's been consolidating here on the hourly charts all day so far. Let's take it back out to its daily chart. Sorry, I've got the bottom lopped off of my charts here, but they're too scrunched up when I have to fit them into the box for the YouTube recording. So it's a fairly small range day so far. So bear that in mind. Small range day at the moment. And so it still has the potential to very much expand its range. Bear that in mind. I don't know which way It could be back up to the upside. But if it does decide to break down, from an ATR perspective, it's certainly got some room. Now, the average true range has really picked up in recent days, but prior to that, it was much smaller, but that was when the market was going up. So usually when the market comes down, the ranges pick up a bit. So I would still expect this range to expand at some point as we go through this afternoon. So the gloves are off, really. So we're just going to see what happens here this afternoon. I'm not going to chase markets. It's really just, it's more likely I would trade the S&P if it retraces up, then I would short it. And likewise with the euro or the dollar CAD. So literally just waiting, waiting, waiting. What happens if they just carry on? If dollar CAD carries on, I'm not going to chase it. If euro dollar comes down, carries on coming down. Likewise with the S&P, I'm not going to chase them. Sometimes you just have to let the market do its own thing. If it's not your style to sell a breakdown, sometimes it is. I will sell breakdowns and buy breakouts, but that's only in certain conditions. So if that's not your style, that trade doesn't belong to you. It doesn't matter if it breaks down and then has a massive run. That's for another trader out there who that does belong to their style. So you have to be true to yourself. That's what's really cool. Little quote there from Starsky and Hutch the movie. But yeah, you've got to be true to yourself and true to your style and your plan. So you don't have to trade every move. And it does mean that some moves won't be appropriate for you and you have to let the market go. So anyway, I'm going to carry on watching as we go through this afternoon. I've got a feeling that we're going to see some expansion of these ranges one way or t'other. And it's just a case of whether I get to get in on any of this or not. So I'll press pause for now. Okay, so just come back now. It's now 4:38 and we're just going to do a quick review here. This is the euro dollar and it had a bit of a bounce, but I've been with the guys here all day. There's still 50 odd of us here and it's just not, the euro didn't bounce enough to short it. And so, and then dollar CAD never retraced enough to get long. So, and that, you know, it's okay. It's benefited my existing open positions. So I'm sitting on a total of about we'll call it 2,500 open positions here for the week. So these positions were initiated both yesterday and then the S&P was initiated at the beginning of the week. So, and that's it for the week, really. But no live trades there today, unfortunately. Sometimes you just have to look at the market and say, yep, we've been moving around a bit here today, but they've just not. The dollar CAD didn't retrace enough for me this morning and has then just left me to it. But, you know, it comes back down to just having that, the willpower to be able to sit on your hands, as Jim Rogers used to say. You know, you make your money sitting on your hands. And what he means by that is both once you're in trades and holding on to them, but also waiting for the right trades to come along and not just chasing markets because they're moving. So I'll quickly go to the S&P. That one's been up and down and chopping around all day. So nothing too much to say on that. We'll see how they all close tonight. I don't know, but we're 20-5. It's time for me to call this show over for the day. So take care. Enjoy your weekends. Sorry there's no actual live trades here today, but that's the way it goes. Take care for now. See you next week.